Small test I did just to get a feeling how good Wikipedia is on artists, and also to see the difference when you have a free text research search or just or you connect it with properties. So for example, what we see here is you have a list box. If I reload this page, first a Sparkle search is done on P2432. Then we get 848 people back. So if we check on the JavaScript, this is the select. Find everything who has P2432, and then it returns it in item label, and then we do a append it to the list box. When I search in, select in the list box, a free text is done. So now we get 106 people back, and this is the URL we use. So if you check that, you can see it's JSON, we get 106 people back, and we also get this as a snippet from this API. So that means that you have a span class, so then you can mark, as I have done with blue. See what's the name of it, it's search match. So then I say dark blue in the color. I have to read, no, there it is. So then if I find a person here, this is not a good name, I think we should have a Henneken. Then I get two hits. If I go down and then Pierre Russell, I get 400, but then I think this one is a good hit. I guess. But then we get a lot of noise. So then I could also select Italy. And I didn't get a hit. Germany. Then I got. So this gets a feeling how good it is to text retrieve and how much information it exists about artists. And my feeling, at least for the Swedish Wikipedia, it's not so good as I thought it should be. So it's just a small test. If we look at the source, you can click here and change it. This is the source I use for this animation, a toolkit called WOW. I have this search Sparkle, searching on the property. Then I add two events. If I change the language box, and if I change the artist box, and then we have the retrieval function. So he checks what's in the name selected and what's in the language box, says 400, and then I use classic as search profile. You can read about the API. Then it could be changed to say that the first one should be the one with most number of viewers and so on. And then we have a Ajax retrieval. I send in this question, not so much error handling. And then here I loop the search result. And then I create this small box and add some animation slide left. And when that has been done, everything is outputted in the output div tag. So here is adding more languages, it's just adding this one, and then you have the short form there, and this one is not used. I thought about adding that, it's for a different way of optimizing the searching. And then we put everything out in the output tag. So I've done this for more properties. This is 7,500 I retrieve, and it takes some time. And then when I select this person, it's just searching in the Swedish Wikipedia. One theory I have is that here we have a correct one, but this is a really good source. But we don't use the source so much, is my theory. So here is the one, which is excellent research. And I think in the Swedish Wikipedia we are not as good using sources as we should. Good luck. And if you would like to use it, do it yourself, you can just click edit and then you fork it and then you have your own version. And adding a language is just this Lix box, I think, somewhere. Ah, it's the wrong one. Sorry. Here we have the Getty Museum. And then you just add another one. Like that. And then when we run it, we will see XXX down here. And if I select it, it will crash, I guess. Yeah. Here we are. It's from Danish's DA. Good luck.